Lil Wayne's latest album, The Funeral, proved that his fans truly love him. He sold a lot of copies the first week. He also proved that he could change with the times. Lil Wayne is probably the only rap artist that actually rap with the millennials like he started that style, which he is part responsible for mumble rap, right along with Soulja Boy, that style of southern mumble rapping like the Migos. Lil Wayne was doing that shit too, you know, because he's a what you would consider lyricist. Wayne could switch his style up like no other, and he is always in the GOAT conversation when it comes to greatest rappers of all time, because I give respect where respect due. The man has a catalog that's probably only compared to like Tupac or Eminem. The man stays in the studio. Now, with that being said, that still don't excuse him for supporting Donald Trump. He lost a lot of fans in the black community. This man clearly saw some type of profit in what Trump was saying about the taxes, because he is rich. And maybe Donald Trump could get him out of the trouble that his ass is facing right now, because apparently Lil Wayne might be going back to prison again. The link for this article will be in the description. So Lil Wayne, charged with gun possession, faces 10 years in prison. Yeah, man. So this is what's going on, people. Lil Wayne is facing a federal weapons charge that could land him in jail. So on Tuesday, which is today, November the 17th, the U.S. Attorney for the Southern District of Florida charged the rapper with one count of possession of a firearm and ammunition by a convicted felon, reports TMZ. Now, if he is convicted, he faces up to 10 years in prison. The charge stems from Wayne's trip to Miami on December the 23rd of 2019, when the federal agents discovered the weapon during a search of his private plane at a Miami Opa-locka executive airport. As a convicted felon from over a decade ago, Wayne wasn't supposed to be in possession of a weapon, according to the Miami Herald. Now, he reportedly admitted to owning a gold-plated pistol, which was found in the luggage, along with bullets, suspected cocaine, ecstasy, heroin, and cough syrup. Now, do you believe that Lil Wayne has truly done, like, all these drugs? And it's just burnt his brain out? Like, you know, it's almost like looking at a goblin for real. So what's a goon to a goblin? All right, so cops also found over 25,000 in cash. Wayne's attorney said his client was cleared to leave despite guns and drugs reportedly found on the jet. He is scheduled to appear in court in Miami on December 11th of this year. So 50 Cent also weighed in on Wayne's legal drama while referencing Wayne's support for Donald Trump. And this is the tweet that he tweeted out, saying, I see. Wait a minute, Trump still got 60 days left. Call him, Wayne. Get that fool on the phone. They're gonna try to put you in jail for supporting Trump. ABC for life tomorrow at 10 p.m. So 50 Cent is so fake when it comes to social media. King of trolling. This nigga be capping, and he's all about a bag. So, I mean, I stopped fucking with 50 as far as just buying his merchandise when he first said he was gonna vote for Trump. Then he tried to be like, I was bullshit. I think 50 Cent is another motherfucker that goes anywhere, does anything that benefits him. I don't think he gives a fuck about nobody else. And Lil Wayne is like that as well, because you said you was voting for Trump, then you changed to 50. Now you trying to make a joke out of Lil Wayne supporting Trump. But both of you motherfuckers are fake when it comes to that shit to me. You should have just been like, in the beginning, Trump is a fake motherfucker who don't give a damn about nobody but rich people. Simple. What do you guys think about Lil Wayne? Probably gonna get some fair time, unless he spend a lot of money. Or maybe he'll snitch, like a lot of these niggas do. Who knows? This is 2020. Like this video, leave your comment, share this on social media, and subscribe.